Yeah, that bear attack happened at the Yellowjacket Campground near Union Valley Reservoir, and that is northeast of Pollock Pines. We have live team coverage on this story from the ground and the air, but we're beginning tonight with KCRA3's Tom Duhane. Tom.
Yeah, it was a dangerous and frightening encounter for a young family from Placerville, a man, his wife, and his young daughter, and it happened right behind me. We're going to push in. You're going to see a tent with a blue awning and some white mosquito netting. That is where the family kept their food last night, and that's what the bear was after. About 2 a.m., a family in these tents heard a commotion. With a flashlight, a Placerville man spotted a bear digging into an ice chest. He yelled to scare the bear away, but it didn't work. He was attacked right at those two stumps.
The bear was removing an ice chest from his a nylon tent and was in the process of consuming the food in the ice chest, and so he tried to shoo the animal away, yelled at it, and the animal pretty much squared him off and looked at him and according to his statement, charged him and closed the gap pretty quickly and then swiped him a couple of times in the head area.
The man fired a .45 caliber handgun at the bear, possibly hitting it. The bear fled. The victim required 26 stitches in the face. He's been treated and released from Marshall Hospital. Meanwhile, the other campers here at the Yellowjacket Campground have been warned.
Well, they've been advised of the situation just to be aware that, you know, we're going to be looking for this animal and to be cautious and aware of what took place.
Mm-hmm. And maybe being cautious with their food?
Correct, yeah. I mean, you know, leaving food out is the attractant, and that's what causes the problem in the beginning.
And meanwhile, back here at the scene, all the family's camping belongings, their tent, their sleeping bags, all their food, everything is still within this cordoned off area as this investigation continues. Meantime, fishing game wardens tonight hunting for a small black bear. They say between 150 and 200 pounds that has been seen before in this area. And they say that the tracking dogs are looking for it. When they find it, they are going to kill the bear because they say once it has attacked a human, it is not safe to relocate the bear. It could happen again. Reporting live in El Dorado County, Tom Duhane, KCRA3 reports.
What can you say? It's an unfortunate situation either way you look at it. Thanks for that, Tom. Dan Shively and Livecopter 3 HD are above the Union Valley Reservoir right now for the latest on that search for the bear, although I don't know how you're going to find it with all the trees out there, Dan.
Boy, you said a mouthful right there, Gulston. It is really difficult. As I mentioned earlier, you know, there could be 100 people down there in the woods and you'd never see any of them from up here. And if you are familiar with the Sierra or any wooded area, you know just how difficult it is to find anything there, especially if it's trying to hide from you. You know, anyone who's ever spent any time in the woods knows that you're walking around and probably within a 50-foot radius or 100 feet, there's probably all kinds of creatures that you never see, but they are there. But this is the area. You can see that parts of it up here have been heavily logged, some clear cut. Some of that clear cut area is still clear. Others have grown back, but it's still, look at that, you get from a clear cut into dense forest, making any kind of tracking of any animal difficult, let alone one particular. But there are a lot of skilled trackers and skilled tracking dogs working on this, so you know, there's a chance they may find that particular bear, especially if it's been wounded. That's the situation up here, a needle in a haystack. Back to you.
That's exactly what that looks like from where you sit. Okay, Dan, thanks.